Oh yo. Let me put it here first.
Yes, see what you.
NIMC hack, NIMC account. I be hacker had NIMC account. I be they shall hack NIMC account. Allegedly, no. I saw it on this lover and Linda. In case, just in case you want to come and carry me, allegedly, they said they have hacked NIMC. So you know that Ojo not long, they were shouting, screaming, everything, go and do your N9N. And my fellow Nigerians were trying to do, they chatting though that they were gonna shut our system down, shut our network down, you will not come online, you will not do this one, you will not do that one. Me, as a very responsible Nigerian, me, I don't even like breaking rules, you people know. I went to do my N9N. If you see the queue that we queue, you will think it is judgment day that we are queuing for. Now at the N9N, what did we use it for? Even people that did not do good, even making jest of us and everything. I'm sure people that did not do, now they will be happy that, I did my own as a good citizen of Nigeria. But I'm never trying to, let me not even think about the stress I went through Kimu on this NIMN day. Kimu is a mini number one, a mini kini, you won't look in it. After I prove our palo join you. Now, what happened? They said they've hacked NIMC account. No, this bad that you are saying, it's not as if I'm leaving Nigeria. I am not leaving Nigeria. I am on my way to the bank to go and carry my money that is remaining. My 3,500 never to cool in no account to me. I am gonna carry it. I'm going to carry it. Living in Nigeria, like, God, if somebody can actually survive Nigeria, I swear, we deserve heaven. Nigerians, you know, God, just give us that gateway to heaven. If you can survive in Nigeria, like, we can survive anywhere else. That's why when Nigerians travel outside, you see them doing well and everything. I swear, you'll just be in your house, you'll be praying. Make stray bullets to not come and eat inside your house. Fire accident should not happen. Amoba should not come. They should not come and kidnap. And then go out. Let me enter online. You see that this one have happened. This one has happened. Nothing is safe in this country. Even the oxygen that we breathe. They say that the thing is now showing you black carbon monoxide. What? Kilo day. Money we say we just put for our account. We say they give us hope. We can use and do subscription. We can use and come online to give ourselves joy. What happened? We say we not hack. But that hacker, if you are watching this, what you do, you know good though. I'm not fighting for the NIMC, it does not even concern me, but you know where you're supposed to go hack. You know. Not your fellow people. From what I read and from my research, they said the person, what you saw like 2 months ago, that is going to be hacking, is coming on hacking spray on African countries, hacking internet websites, banks, network, and everything. In fact, first of all, that's for you guys to know the level of security in this country. Even NIC account is not saved. NIC, National Identity Commission or something. I don't even know the full meaning, but that way I'll put it. So if they can hack NIMC, so what are you that? What can they not hack? What can they not? Anyways, get it right. I am on my way to my bank. To go and carry my remaining money. Isn't that what a normal Nigerian like me is supposed to do? Calm down! It's not as bad as you think. Calm down. See, just like as you saw the news, and I saw the news too, the first thing that came to my head is, yeah, TV5 for me. That my brother just sent me thank you. TV5 me toku. I felt like hack. That was the first thing that came to my mind. But then I was like, cannot be as bad as it is. So I called one of my friends that actually works in the bank, and I tried to ask him what are the implications of this N99 thing. My morning, what's gonna happen? That kind of thing. And he actually told me, calm down, it's not as bad as it is. And that's why I am actually making this video too. It is not as bad as it is. It is NIN, not your BVN. So two things they are supposed to happen. Two things. I don't know that first one is not concerned my fellow Nigerian, just like me too. Because I actually went online. I tried to look for implications of data compromise or what are the possibilities of this that could happen. And the first thing I saw was identity theft. More work, which is better to watch the only one man's identity theft, which is concerned, but at least it's actually important. So when as allegedly the way NIMC website was actually hacked, though they've come out to debunk it too, but let's just see. The two possible things that can happen is, number one is identity theft. Wait, we still talk about the money side, but let's talk about this one, you know? The identity theft, which is maybe somebody like try to impersonate you for your name, your picture, your so many things, different way of different ways of actually impersonating, just like you just be in your house and then somebody will be helping you to buy something in US, or somebody should help you to buy something in Ghana, or you should be in Lagos, somebody should be helping you to buy something in Abuja. Or something should happen, police should come to your account, you're under arrest for what? You for murder of Mr. Colin Pekon. Like something like that, me that I did not go anywhere. Yeah, that is identity theft. They can use your name, your data, your anything for anything that they like, and that is what happens. Like since there is actually like allegedly a compromise on the NIMC website. Remember when you actually registering for your in, and that most of you did not do it, but just in case we that did it, they asked for our name, our phone number, our address, date of birth. Like, we gave them just everything about our personal data, so they can just clone it. You understand? To just do all sort of things, all sort of madumadu. See, all those things never happen because people say why. Even police enter my house and say, "I need to go and kiss somebody." Well, okay, that was just like identity theft. I hope you understand that one. So now, according to accounts, we talk about money, because even if they say that now you commit this crime, at least if you still have money. To at least you that's what I'm trying to say. What would I see giving somebody up? You get what I'm trying to say. There is no way they can actually hack directly into your account. It is not possible. There's a difference between NIN, which is your national identity national identity number, and BVN, which is your biometric verification number. Oh shit, I don't know. I just think, yeah. So there's actually a difference between the two of it, you got me. So is NIN that they hack? It is not BVN. So just calm down. There is no way they can actually directly hack into your account unless the bank gang is trying to play a fast one on you, or they will just try to say, "Hey, is the hacker." It is not possible. NIN don't hack. So, but the only thing that can happen is there will be more increase. There will be high rate of more crime. There will be increasing crime rates, like, you know, this crime rate, that's why we just call you, there's a problem with your account and Kinecom. So what will actually happen is that these hackers, they will actually make it possible for their fellow hackers that don't just share, but to have access to more phone numbers and more email address. So you actually wonder at time when somebody just calls you, some people actually even get your bank and we're calling you from, like, some people just call you to just say they are calling you from so bank and you have a problem with your account, this is your commander. Some people even mention the name of your bank, or you'll be surprised. We know that one are interacting within the bank, you understand? But some just calls, they just talk randomly, they don't even know the bank you're using. All those ones, we know say this one are baby tea. So now that they've actually possibly allegedly hacked into NIC account, they will just call you a bank, Mr. or Mrs. Togbelegbe, that you are using Kinecom bank. Something happened to your account that you use, they will give you the exact details. Like exact details, but then just like the same thing they do, so they will have more access to more phone numbers and more email address. So, and if you know that your ways to deal with me, all the shout you've been shouting since when somebody call you, don't give out your personal data, your Kinecom, is their time, you will fall for it. So when you fall for it, just know that it's your hand that used to do your hand yourself. That's why I have to tell people what to move by. If you like, call me 100 times. If I don't have your number on my phone, I am not picking. Let you send me a text message, say, "Ah, this is who you have a making back call. Take for me, so for me, over to my money, if I keep a back. Oh dear, for mama love, I am not gonna pick." So, after they act this account, that's how somebody just chatted me on WhatsApp. Tonique is from Kinecom Bank. I just send my, the way he even said it, gone. Oh, if you come and see, I sent my SMB, my, oh God, which one are you picking? I mean, I won 80,000. That kind of thing. So that is possibly something like that can actually happen. Like a stranger just calling you randomly, texting your WhatsApp, telling you you want something. And if you know that Ojukwu is your first name, if you know that covetousness and greedy name is in your middle name, is in your everything, you actually fall for it. And maybe when I saw the message, I don't know, but possibly that is just what will happen. So this is me making this video. Guys, you need to be extra careful. We need to be extra careful. And I should be making a separate video. If you know that you have a phone number linked to your account, this thing, may I have two phones, you got me? Even if I cannot afford two Android phones or iPhone, get a small phone, 2 or 2, Kelebe, all those 2-5, I don't know how much they're selling phone or this thing or whatever it is. See, no matter whoever kidnapped me or this thing, you can never see my phone number that is linked to my account with me. Do not go outside with your normal phone number linked to your account. In fact, possibly just get a new number. That one should be for your account alone. If somebody call you on that line, don't pick it. That's why my second line, if somebody call me like this, if it's not my mother, my father, if it's not my parents, I don't pick. So that one should just be like your important phone number and always stay. Just put it in the house. The other one, if you like the kids, if you like, even if you are like, so guys, we really need to be extra careful. And another thing, I'm sure you guys know, do not put your money inside your ATM card. I know we don't shout this one tire. There is no opening bank account is free in Nigeria. Opening, you only just to go there, queue, submit your passport, submit your this thing. You can have up to 10 different accounts. When you have your ATM, like somebody like me, now if you carry my ATM, there is no one that you can meet zero. Do 10,000. That 10,000 is because I just transferred it instead because I wanted to go and buy something or 20k. I mean, even 10 or 40 go is because I want to go and do full day shopping, full month shopping. That's the highest amount you can see inside my ATM card. I really don't understand how people actually work with ATM card with plenty money inside. When they now see you, be crying. I understand it's painful and everything, but then if it's still small money, you will still cry and drink tea. But if it's big money, it's as if your whole life is actually this thing. So you have two accounts. One is your major biz accounts, major. When you need money, you transfer from the major one to the small one, and you will carry the card. Even when somebody beg you for money, you say, auntie, see my account balance. I don't have money. I don't have shingai. So that's why even your ATM card, you use it for swapping, you use for buying, you use for this, you use for so many things. Nobody will hack it. Even if those people that used to use powder and blow somebody, if they blow it, the only money they will see in your account will do 5,000 or more. You understand? They will even be beating you. Stop carrying big money inside your ATM card. Don't shout this one, tire. I don't know. It will not take you how many minutes to go to the bank to open an account. Fix some. Save some. I used to have a fixed deposit account. That was the money I used for my business. Because everything is simple. Now, I don't know. Understand? Even if it is 20k you used to collect every month, let one be your salary account. Come and be 20k. Yes, to buy any double. Even if it's 2k, transfer it. Is it that 53 naira that they will collect for you and that is paying you or what? That one and this one, which is better? So from now, that I said, come and tell you guys today. Oh, I did not plan to make this video. I hope you like this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And hey, we'll see my next video. And then you see, your money should be book. Keep my money. So, guys, so far, that's the possible thing that can happen. They cannot take your money directly from the bank unless your bank is just trying to play or your intelligence. And please don't fall for a call. If anybody call you at this time, don't peek. Okay, Motisatemito. You see the way things are getting costly in Nigeria. So guys, thanks for watching today's video, and I'll see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.